Hi guys, hope you all are doing amazing. So today I'm going to try out a couple of new launches from Wet n Wild. I have their stick foundations here and I also have their makeup sponge and one of their new eyeshadow palettes and couple of new lipsticks that look like Pat McGrath lipsticks. So I have quite a lot of new launches and I think I picked them around last month, but I couldn't film a video because of a lot of other reasons. So let's get started without wasting much time. So I'm going to start with moisturizing my face and I'm using Pixi Phenomenal Gel. So this moisturizer from Pixi is pretty good. It hydrates your skin and it's a gel texture, which means it's not going to feel heavy or greasy on the skin. Yeah, so Wet n Wild has launched these Photo Focus stick foundations in I think 10 shades. So 10 shades are available on HOK Makeup and I think 6 are available on Nykaa. So I have picked 2 of them. So this is cream beige, this is amber. Cream beige is pretty light and amber looks quite peachy, I'm not sure. I will start with amber as all over color. I think it's too peach toned. I'm not sure, let's see how it looks once I blend it in. I also have this makeup sponge from them. It's already damp and ready to go. So even the amber looks pretty light on me. It's really confusing to buy foundation online. I thought it will be a good match because I checked swatches online. So coverage wise, I think it offers very natural looking coverage. It's actually a shade lighter than my complexion, so it is looking grey. I'm taking cream beige and applying it under my eyes as my concealer. So concealer under my eyes is also done. In fact, I had this Wet n Wild Photo Focus concealer in the shade deep medium with me, but I thought, you know, I should give these a shot. And my face is looking pretty grey. So next I'm going to quickly apply some powder on my face. And I'm using my Kiko Baked powder in the shade 4. See, it's taking away all the grey tone from my face. It's not a matte foundation stick. It's more on the dual creamier side. It's more creamy on me. Next I'm using Wet n Wild blush in the shade Mellow Wine. This is like my all time favorite blush. It's really good. It's matte and the color looks really pretty. Even if you're going out during the day and you just want a flush of color on your cheeks, this is a good one. This is for $2.99. To bronze, I'm using the contouring palette in the shade Caramel on the perimeters of my face. Next, I'm going to use this Wet n Wild eyeshadow palette in the shade Stop Playing Safe. I'm going to use the shade Transition. Next, I'm going to use this one. So the colors are nice. I'm going to apply this one. I'm going to use this Color Bar Blackout Eye Pencil. So my eyeliner is done. Next, I'm going to use Brow Pomade in the shade Espresso from Wet n Wild. This is a new product. So this isn't the shade for me. I mean, none of them worked for me well. I mean, though both the shades are very light. The amber one has peachy tone, so it's not going to work on my skin tone. And the other one is yellow, but it's very light. It almost looks like chalk on my hand. So the foundations, the finish is okay. They will give you very skin-like finish. Nothing too heavy or cakey. It's difficult when you buy foundation online, you end up with wrong products the way I have today. Next, I'm going to apply a little bit of mascara, an okayish mascara, but I wanted to keep it mostly Wet n Wild. I have 2 lipstick options. These are High Shine Brilliance lipsticks. This is made for mauve and Raining Rubies looks beautiful. So this is a High Shine color, so it gives you beautiful shine, and it's very comfortable on the lips. It's very glossy. Last step would be setting the makeup. So this is the finished makeup look. I really struggled with the foundation shade. It did not work for me. It made my face pretty gray. So I had to go back and apply a little bit of my this Makeup Forever powder. I use this because this is like a shade darker than my skin tone. So it neutralizes the gray tones. Whenever I have gray tone, I apply a little bit of it on that area, especially the area around my mouth. Personally, I did not like the foundations. Maybe because of the tones, but they applied nicely, they blended in nicely. The finish is very natural looking, and the coverage would be medium. The eyeshadow palette was okay. I mean, there was nothing too exciting about it. So yeah, this is my finished makeup look. And also, I have a small giveaway for you guys. So I have reached 1 lakh subscribers here, and I really wanted to do a small giveaway, and I did not want to make a special giveaway video, so I thought I'll include the giveaway here in this video, and I might do more such giveaways in future. So if you are new here, do not forget to hit that subscribe button. So I'm going to show you what all you can win in this giveaway. Kaya brightening serum. Here is the serum. You have Kaya spot corrector, Kaya daily pore minimizing toner, activated charcoal anti-pollution face wash from Kaya. There is an eye cream from Kaya. Then I have 2 brand new lipsticks from Wet n Wild. The total value of the hamper is going to be around 4,000 to 5,000. So these are the products that one of you can win. So do not forget to subscribe, hit that like button, and comment which product you are most excited about. I'm going to announce a winner randomly under the same video in 5 days from now. I'll mention each and everything in the description box. Do not forget to read everything before you decide to participate. Yeah, that's about it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video. If you did, do not forget to give it a big thumbs up. If you are watching me for the first time, please subscribe, and I'll see you very, very soon in my next video. Till then, bye.